I went through a lot of despair, being upset that I'm a single mom.
I used to get so frustrated. No matter what you're doing, it's almost like in quicksand.
You had collectors calling you, and you don't have the money to pay, and they don't care.
We found each other, now we say, the world is ours.
You're looking behind, and you see all this debt, and you're like, what's going on here?
The only place you can get without a map is lost.
Money, money, money.
My name is Favel. I am 31 years old. I have three children, 7 years and 5 years and a newborn.
My name is Twain and I'm 37. I'm a supervisor for the Transit Commission and make approximately $70,000.
I met my husband on the job. Right now I'm on maternity, but previously I was a transit operator. We've been together for a year and 7 months.
My debt was just encompassed in a relationship where debt became a problem. Then I just said, I'll take the debt which we accomplished as a couple. I can move on with life and know that it's all taken care of.
I have a lot of financial baggage because of past relationships. I have two kids and their father was not in their lives. I went through a lot of despair and I've thought about giving them up, giving them away just for them to have a better life. You know, you had collectors calling you and you don't have the money to pay and they don't care. So are they gonna garnish your wage or are they gonna go after your little money that you're relying on to buy diapers or milk or whatever?
I hate that. To be with somebody that understands that, it's completely refreshing.
He's true and true a godsend. One of the things that we both have in common is that we hate debt. We both want to move forward now because we've now started a life and we don't want to bring baggage from the past into it.
No matter how fast you're running, no matter how much more you're working, you're still falling behind.
You feel like you're going, but you're looking behind and you see all this debt and you look at it and you're like, okay, I'm not spending a lot of money. What's going on here?
You start to get to a point where you start spiraling, thinking you can't do it, can't do it, can't do it. It's becoming overwhelming.
I know I can get out of it, but I need assistance. Someone else that they live and breathe money.
And who's gonna get us there? Gail.
This month, I'll help this couple move from red to black. I've been solving money problems for over 20 years, tackling everything from high finance to low income. I help people understand money and debt, which is still a huge mystery for most folks. And it's the number one reason couples split up. So now I'm making house calls. Favel and Twain's past mistakes are haunting their future together. They make good money, so they can't understand why the debt's still growing. Their dreams of being a big, happy family in their own home have to be put on hold until they see the light.
Hi! Gelfaz Oxlade, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This growing family of five is crammed into Favel's old three-bedroom apartment.
These children don't have a lot of stuff.
They're not spending their money on personal luxuries.
Again, a very frugal family. I'm not used to seeing a TV that small in anybody's house.
No, you have a nice family, you have a beautiful family. You have
Thank you.
Gorgeous, healthy children. And you're planning to adopt.
Yes.
And you've recently gotten married.
Yes.
A lot of changes happening.
A lot of changes.
What is your big goal?
Probably would be the house. We know that the finances are coming.
But why are you still thinking about your debt like two individuals?
I guess because we just haven't had that plan to come forward and say, which is the best way to go? Do we go with both the same account and then we pay everything from that? Or do we still kind of keep going the way in which we're going? That's probably some information that we do need.
Could it also be that you felt that you should clean up your mess?
True. Yep.
And you should clean up your mess.
That's exactly how I think.
You know, there are no more individual problems. You are now one big, huge problem.
Yeah.
You actually don't even know how much you're paying in terms of your debt. You said you were paying just around 500 and change. But when you take off the car loan payment, it means that on $36,000 worth of debt, $37,000 almost, you are actually only making payments that total about $130. I don't think the department store or the cell phone company, the student loan people, are going to be very happy with the fact that you aren't making regular payments. Then what happens is that registers at the credit bureau. There's a repercussion for it.
Right.
when I asked you to do up a budget, there were some areas where you didn't even indicate what you were spending, and some areas where you thought you were spending a certain amount, but you were actually spending much more. For example, on average, you're a real boozer, aren't you? You spend a whole $6 a month on booze. Yeah, go nuts. Mm. But you are spending $21.56 on kid stuff, $25.73 in an automotive store, $28.72 in restaurants. It doesn't sound like a lot. You think to yourself, it's not even $10 a week. How can that be a problem? Mm-hmm. Go ahead and add it up. What you find is you're spending over $1,200 a month on a whole bunch of stuff. And that's not the cash. This is just the stuff we can track from debit or credit cards. So give me your best guess at how much you spend in cash every month.
$1,200. $2,800. $2,800.
Wow. You thought you were really good, didn't you? You thought I was going to come here and you were going to say to me, we knew that. Are you surprised?
I'm a person that talks a lot, so the fact that I'm not talking, I'm stuck. Wow.
You're actually overspending every month by about $1,900. And if you keep it up in 5 years, you'll have $200,000 worth of consumer debt. And do you think you're going to be able to get into a house with $200,000 worth of debt and your crappy credit history?
Not a chance.
Not a chance. So, are you going to do anything I ask you to do over the next 3 or 4 weeks?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Over the next few weeks, I'm going to give you a series of challenges to do. If you do the challenges to my satisfaction, I'll give you up to $5,000 to help you pay down the debt. You don't do the challenges, you don't get the money. Moving forward, what we're going to do is we're going to fix the problems you have in your spending plan. We're going to deal with your crappy credit history. And we're going to get you guys going from dreaming together to making your dream a reality.
Okay.
Sound good?
Yes.
Great.
Okay, go get me your credit cards and debit cards, because they're gone. Coming up, getting Favel and Twain to spread the word about debt.
He's not going to bite you.
I promise I won't bite.
Money, 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 money.
While Favel was struggling as a single mother,
I was told that I'm going to have to do this solo with no support from my previous relationship.
Twain's first experience with marriage and money ended badly.
I don't like debt. We used to argue about the fact, well, you don't want any debts. No, I don't want any debt.
When they found each other, they thought they'd also found a financial soulmate. But they're not as good with their money as they think. You're overspending every month by about $1,900.
Their big dream is to escape Favel's cramped apartment.
We're busting at the seams, really. You wouldn't want to put anything more in here.
And do you think you're going to be able to get into a house with $200,000 worth of debt and your crappy credit history?
If they want to make their dreams a reality, they're going to have to follow my rules. For the next month, this couple will learn to live on a strict cash budget. No more credit cards. They'll complete weekly challenges to tackle their money and relationship issues. And if they're willing to change, I'll reward them with thousands of dollars. No changes, no money.
So I'm actually going to cut your variable expenses by 70%. 70%. You were spending about $5,400 and now you'll be spending about $1,600. You will have $150 a week for food, $81.25 for transportation.
A week?
A week. Entertainment, $35.50. Clothing and gifts, $31.25. $32.50 for other. While you're living on cash, you have to write it down. Because remember all that cash you've been running through?
Yes.
You don't know where it's gone because you never wrote it down. Now you have the budget binder. Mm. And the budget binder will let you track everything that you're spending. So you know exactly where you stand.
The jars was a big wake-up call. It just looked like such a small amount to go through the whole month with.
One of the things you guys need to do is understand your credit history and the things you can do to fix it. You can go online and apply for a credit bureau report on yourselves, and you're going to do that this week. And then you are going to spread the gospel. I have found an extremely busy bus stop.
Okay.
And you will be wearing these T-shirts. You are going to put your credit rating in the box. Then you are going to tell people what that means.
Uh-huh.
how to check their credit histories, and how important it is that they do it, because it's also a way to guard yourself against identity theft.
The most commonly used credit rating is an R score. An R1 means you pay your bills on time. The higher the R score, the more inconsistent you are with your payments. An R9 means you've gone to collections or filed for bankruptcy, and that's bad news.
I don't mind too much showing the R rating part of it, but if it had been I'm this much in debt, I'd be a little, not as comfortable.
He's not gonna bite you.
I promise I won't bite.
The challenge, because I'm a very private person, exposing myself to people, that's gonna be the challenge.
We're here to talk about credit. You guys know your credit ratings? You know what your credit rating is?
No.
I know it's bad.
Oh, bad like me? I'm the nine, he's the one.
Take this, contact any one of those people. You can go online and purchase your information. You can see.
Your credit rating not only sticks with you now, but for the next 10 years.
Bad credit.
Bad credit? Why
yeah,
is that?
Why?
Why?
Why? I'm not getting enough money, and I can't pay my payments on time. I'm damaged.
You're damaged? Damaged. But you can fix it.
Paying your bills that you have right now, knowing the debt, whatever's outstanding, charging less right now, not closing all accounts after you pay it off.
It shows that you can actually keep credit and you're not going to get yourself in debt.
You can resurrect.
You've
it's
got time.
All right.
Yeah, not the end of the world.
Absolutely, it's not the end of the world. You're right. Okay.
Do you see all these very busy people around us? Mm-hmm. Are you wondering why we're here? They know more about your credit history than you did before you checked your credit histories.
That's right.
And that should never happen. Nobody should know more about your credit history than you. If you see a problem, you can fix it, and there are ways to fix it. And one of the best ways to fix it, guess what, is to use your credit.
Right.
Because what you want to do is reestablish a good pattern. You never carry a balance every single month. Paid within 30 days, paid within 30 days, paid within 30 days, and then you get your R1 rating back. Which brings me to your challenge.
Mm.
For you, I have the allowance kit.
Okay.
Now you're gonna have an opportunity to educate your kids about money.
Wow.
They have their own jars.
Mm-hmm.
They will decorate their jars any way they want.
They will love that, yeah.
Let me start by telling you my philosophy on allowance. An allowance is the money that you normally spend on your children, put in your children's hands so they can learn to manage it themselves. You just go back over your budget and decide what you're gonna take out of the jars.
Gotcha.
For their jars.
To their jars, okay.
Yeah, to make sure they have what they need so that they can get smart about money from a young age. And let me tell you something, girl, this works.
Money.
Newlyweds Favel and Twain are also new parents, creating a new family together.
We found each other, now we say the world is ours.
I feel like I'm starting over life.
They had lots of debt and bills and collections from past mistakes, but weren't doing enough to fix the problem.
You're never gonna pay off $36,000 in debt, making $130 payments.
They can earn up to $5,000 to pay down that debt if they accomplish all my challenges. I've shown them how to be in control of their finances, and the next challenge is to pass it on.
The thing is that nobody taught you.
That's right.
And that's how you got into this mess.
We have our jars, and you guys are gonna have your jars.
Now this is gonna be harder than I thought.
We have a jar for sharing.
We have a spending jar. Then we have the saving jar. The mad money jar, whatever money goes in here, you guys can buy whatever you want. That's the mad money jar. Okay.
It's a good lesson for them to learn now. They're not too young to learn it, primarily because they're already asking about it. So I wish I did have someone to educate me in that. It would have saved me a lot of heartaches.
They will actually let the kids think about the money that they see us spending, because they think it's just endless. The fact that we work, money's always going to be there. But this way, they'll understand that, no, we only have so much that we're going to get, and we can't spend all of it all the time. We'll put in the first week's allowance.
And you got to put the money in your jars, okay?
Yay!
How do they feel about having their own money?
They couldn't wait to get their percentage. It's just like, we get this no matter what.
The lesson that ends up coming out of that for kids as they grow up is, it's not about loving money, it's about understanding how it works. Are you guys actually feeling more optimistic about everything now?
Yeah, we see the big light at the end of the tunnel. Good. Not a little light, we see a big light, good. So.
We are in a movie theater. Do you know why we're in a movie theater?
Not yet.
A couple of seconds, you're gonna know.
Shortly, yeah. But not yet.
This has to do with your relationship rescue challenge, which is your next challenge. You have a relationship to maintain while you're also parents. And that means you have to carve time out for yourselves. One of the reasons you don't go out is because you, ma'am, do not trust anybody to take care of your children.
Yes, that's true.
Okay.
That's true.
You have heard the term, it takes a village?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, you have to build yourself from among your various communities a network of a babysitting swapping, okay, so that you find like-minded couples with children.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You all get a night out, mm-hmm, once a month where you can have a date. So you have to build a network this week. Have a date. Don't disappoint me. No. Be very ugly. Coming up, making a lasting impression on each other.
Look what you got me to do.
Did you bring those sedatives?
Money.
Favel and Twain's big dream is to move their newly blended family of five from this tiny apartment into their own home.
The greatest thing is to turn in that driveway and just know that, okay, I'm home.
But it's not just the debt from failed past relationships holding them back, it's their spending.
You're actually overspending every month by about $1,900.
What was missing was a plan to get them out of debt and saving for their dreams.
The only place you can get without a map is lost.
Through challenges, I've been showing them that roadmap. If they stay on track, they'll earn $5,000 to help them pay down that debt. Their final challenge was to make time for their relationship and go on a date. But dinner and a movie wasn't what they had planned.
The tattoo thing was something we were talking about for a while now, but to actually get here and actually have it done is we had an idea that we knew we wanted. It had to be a family tattoo of sorts that has a special representation that only really we know about.
Look what you got me to do.
Did you bring those sedatives?
We don't spend time together. Free time, what's that? That's just my life. But I understand where Gail's coming from.
Breathe.
Twain?
Yes, baby.
Shut up.
As newlyweds, we still have to make sure we find the time for us. And it was good for us also to get outside of our environment of the house.
Where'd you go on your date?
Tattoo.
Tattoo
parlor.
Show me.
To tell you what it represents. It's the whole family. Mine is a little different than Favel's because mine has F in it for Favel.
You're like a soccer team now.
We're connected.
Yes. What did you learn during the month?
I learned I can open up. And it's not as terrifying as I thought it was going to be, especially with the R9 challenge and being out in the public and stuff. And I learned that I can definitely, you know, depend on T. Like,
sure you can. Yeah. And what did you learn, Twain?
I learned that I actually don't have to have money in my pocket all the time.
Okay. So when I got here, you were spending about $1,900 a month, more than you made, and you were headed to about $200,000 worth of debt. You had a new baby. This was not looking good. Yeah. And you wanted to buy a house, yeah, and you had no hope of ever saving any money as long as you're spending more than you made, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we stemmed the overspending. Mm-hmm. We put $1,000 a month into your budget for debt repayment, and you will be paid off in 16 months.
You serious?
Serious.
Whoa.
I like that.
So we also put $200 in your budget for savings and $100 for emergencies. If you keep putting that $200 away, and then once the debt is paid off, you add another $300 to it, by the time you guys are ready to retire, you'll have $500,000. And you're old, so that's pretty good.
Older. Older.
There's another number in your budget. I have $1,350 set aside as savings for a down payment on a home. When you turn 40, you will have $45,000 to put down on a home so you can move into a home of your own.
The future looks so much more optimistic, where we were kind of like, okay, we'll be able to get into a house. Now it's like, you know what, we can get into the house.
What we did was we took care of your past mistakes, mm-hmm, and we put you on a path to a brighter future in terms of reaching some goals. Mm-hmm. And we got you building a community, and dating again.
Yes.
So that you have the network you need so that you can be a family and a couple.
You guys did a lot.
Mm-hmm. We did. We did a lot during this month.
You did a lot. So I have for you, how much?
5,000.
You're right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All the areas of our lives are going to be managed well. So it's going to be a good feeling going into that. And that's what I was envisioning, was to just feel like everything is okay.
Twain wants to adopt the children.
Uh-huh.
You're going to need some money to help you with the adoption costs.
Yeah.
So here I have for you $1,000 towards your adoption costs so that you can make yourself a whole family.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
No matter where you are in life, you can always do better. And even though you think you're okay, Gail is able to show you that you can get better than where you thought you can. And even the dreams that you had, she can show you how you can surpass those.
Yeah.
Why are you crying then? Happy tears.
Happy tears?
Yes.